Is there anything that beats a good old 6-player cooperative zombie-killed mayhem, especially in this wonderful gory-themed holiday season? Killing Floor 2 is one of the best ways to spend some time with your friends and get in the Halloween mood, especially for an early access game. But it can be a bit intense for a low-end system. I mean, look at all those detailed gory models for enemies. They have so many gross details that make you... Never mind. This is the LowSpecGamer, where we force detailed games to look like indie experimental shooters, half because we like how they look, half because our computers can't really handle a game otherwise. So, forget about shadows, textures, details, and graphics in general, because we are going to make this game run. As of today, Killing Floor 2 is in early access, meaning that a lot of balancing and features are being added. Right now, a preset system does not seem to be in place. This is a default configuration, which is basically a high preset. And high means an average of 15 frames per second just walking around. Kinda expected, but we have seen worse. Let's see how much of a difference the settings do. So, what I have simply done is to set the preset into low for the moment. This puts everything into low or off. There is a good difference in this game. Standing still, I can get something between 25 and 30 FPS. It does start dropping dramatically when enemies are present and when explosions happen. Thankfully, this is a game where there is quite a fair amount of things to tweak. This game has a lot of configuration files, but the best one for our tweaking is located on the following directory. Go to your documents folder, My Games, Killing Floor 2, KF Game, config kfsystemsettings.ini, which you can open with Notepad. Let's start with the simple things. The first lines allows us to disable decals, which are the effects applied to surfaces when hit by bullets or so. We have also this. Dynamic lights. You can turn this off if you're desperate and you get a substantial gain in performance, but it will make your game look really dark. So, your choice. Next, we have this set of values related to shadows and some light environmental effects. You can disable them for a small boost. Then we have fog volumes, which are used for effects and smoke that we can disable. Followed by floating point render targets that disable some post effects. There is also a value called Only Stream In Textures, which we can set to true to tell the game to only load textures in, but not out, and this helps performance in some systems with low memory. Then we have a low radial blur, which on false disables certain explosion effects, and finally allow image reflections and shadowing, which disable reflections when put into false. Now, one of the most interesting ones is Max Draw Distance Scale, which controls the range of the draw distance. 1 means a normal draw distance, and reducing it to 0.7 means 70% of the normal draw distance, which I found to be rarely noticeable. If you lower it to something like 50%, you can really see the impact of the game. Finally, we have textures. We can reduce the game to its absolute flat minimum by going into the first texture group of the file and changing every LOD value to 1. Since this can take a while, the resulting texture lines are in a link in the description so you can copy them from there. Paste them on top of the first texture group, right here. Save the file and we are ready to play. Forget about zeds, now it's trying to fight mannequins or mudmen, whatever you please. With this configuration, I at least see some really stable and nice performance and ooh, look at that fire, that looks really cool. And it does not make the game any easier though. Nope, 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 back, no, no. Kill the mudmen! I can see my individual bullets. Can you see them? They're little squares. Where is the trader? Ooh, look at this crap! Yes, this is awesome! Nice going! Now this is teamwork. Everyone else killing all the zombies while I'm running around lost. Extremely lost. Where is everyone? There, here we go. Ooh, they even break into pieces. That's... whoop. Help. Coming my way to help you. They break into really funny pieces. It's like plastic inside plastic. This is the team of Dream. Yes, extremely competent. Clearly the most competent team. The best ever. What are you doing? Well, at least the colors make it easy to see. Yep, this is the best way to fight this guy. Grenade the fuck out of him and just... the solution to everything is violence. I feel like we have no order or no idea what we're doing. At least I don't have much of an idea of what is going on. This is so chaotic. How is he not dead? This is ridiculous. And this is normal difficulty? We're not even playing any hard. Ah, no! Okay. Woo! Whoa, where the hell did he came from? Whoa! Close. Ooh, those are some great looking mountains. Don't you love this beautiful landscape?
That is all for this episode. I had a lot of fun playing, and I'm glad to say that some of you were arm to arm with me, making this possible. If you want to know about future recordings you can be a part of, consider joining the LowSpecGamer Steam group. I always post announcements when I can include some of you. Now, before we go, I want to announce the results of the last
LowSpecGamer scary giveaway.
Last week, I asked you guys a simple question to be answered over the Steam group or comments. Have you ever played a horror game that simply did not scare you? And the randomly selected winner is SuperShaw201, who was not scared by Slender Mansion. Brave man, or was the game just really not scary? You tell me. Congratulations! Your prize is a Steam copy of Limbo. I will be contacting you shortly. This week, I have an amazing prize, a Steam copy of Killing Floor 2 itself, so you can try these tweaks. I have a very silly question to ask for this week. What is your favorite Halloween candy? I know this is a tricky question since many of us, myself included, do not live in a place where Halloween is actually a thing, but hey, everyone has a favorite candy, right? You can leave me your answers over comments or in the LowSpecGamer Steam group. As always, thank you for watching, participating, liking, and in general supporting me. See you on Halloween for the last special video.